everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.1 RC, or Release Candidate. A Release Candidate is the final version that will be released to the public if there's no additional issues found within it. And so this is available currently to developers and soon to public beta testers. Usually by the time this video is live, it will be available. And as you can see, this is 5.26 gigabytes on my iPhone 13 Pro Max. Anytime you go from a beta version to a final version, you're going to have a very large install as it reinstalls everything. And it was between 4 to 5 gigabytes on the iPhone 12 Pro Max and iPhone 6S Plus that I have here. Along with iOS 15.1 RC, Apple also released iPadOS 15.1 RC that I have on my 12.9 inch iPad Pro from 2021, along with the watchOS 8.1 RC version and tvOS 15.1 RC, along with macOS Monterey RC. That's finally going to be available. And these should be available as soon as next week. In fact, it will be available next Monday as far as macOS Monterey, so you can expect iOS 15.1 around that time frame as well. Now, if you're on the betas and you're wondering how you can get off of the beta to the final version, well, typically if there's additional issues with this update, they'll push out another release candidate, a release candidate 2, and you would need the beta for that. If you don't care about that, you can delete the beta profile now, and then when the final comes out, check for an update. If they used this version, you won't have an update and you just had the final version early. If they do release another one, you'll have an update then as well. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go to general, then about. You can see the build number is 19B74. And this particular build brings some of the features that we've been wanting since the release of iOS 15 that Apple promised, as well as a few additional things as well. Now the first thing is, if you're on beta 4 and you moved to the release candidate, there will not be a modem update for you. So there's no modem update in this version. However, I wanted to go over all the features that they mentioned in the release candidate, starting with SharePlay. SharePlay is something they showed off at WWDC, and they showed off a lot with iOS 15, and then they delayed it. So now it's available, and in 15.1, to use SharePlay, you just need to place a FaceTime call. So I'll call myself, and as you can see here, I have a FaceTime call. It's letting me know that I'm muted, but if you tap on the FaceTime call, you have a couple different options here. You can share your screen now in 15.1. You have that option, which is really nice, but you can also SharePlay, which means you can enjoy music or videos and things with others. It says choose content to use with SharePlay. So you can choose maybe a song to share with someone, a movie, or just sort of enjoy that along with Fitness Plus and other App Store apps that support it. And when you have those available, not only will you have FaceTime with that person, you'll be able to watch those videos together at the same exact time. And controls for those things are given to both people at the same time. So if you're using FaceTime or you're using something else, you'll be able to use them at the same time and then share those controls. Also, Apple TV supports the option to watch shared video on your big screen while you continue the FaceTime call on the iPhone. So it will actually sync between this and Apple TV. So if you want to use a larger screen, you can do that. There's also the addition of Smart Volume, and Smart Volume will lower the audio of a movie, TV show, or song when your friends speak. So maybe you're speaking or someone else is, it automatically pulls back the volume of the music or maybe video or TV that you're watching at the same time. So all of those things are in iOS 15.1. We expected SharePlay, but you'll have that screen sharing ability and all of those additional features as well. If you have an iPhone 13 Pro or iPhone 13 Pro Max, Apple has added ProRes video. This is something they mentioned at the announcement of the iPhone 13 Pro, and they've added the feature with this update. So if you go into your settings, scroll down until you get to your camera. Under camera, go to formats. You'll now see Apple ProRes. This is available for 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max only. It's not available for the iPhone 12 series or any of the older devices. And if you have a 128 gigabyte model or less, you'll have the option for 1080p 60 frames. If you have a 256 up to 1 terabyte storage option, you'll have 4K up to 30 frames per second or 60 frames per second at 1080p. So you'll need that additional storage. I did a video recording in this. It takes a huge amount of storage to record ProRes, but it looks really good. But those options have been added. They've also added the option for automatic camera switching. You can turn that off for macro. So you'll see at the bottom of camera settings, you have auto macro. You can turn that off or on now if you don't want it to automatically switch. So that's something that's new. That ProRes option is within the camera as well. If you go to video, you'll see that it's in the camera. You can turn it on or off here once you enable it. So you'll have that option. And then also for macro, unfortunately, there's not really a macro button. So if you turn on auto macro, if you turn that off, go back over to your photos, there's not necessarily an auto macro where you get close. It doesn't really focus. You need to turn on the macro mode in order for that to work. So there's no easy way to do that, unfortunately. You have to go back, turn on macro mode, go back, and then as you get close to something, it will switch to macro. So there is no additional options for that, but those have been added on the 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max. With iPhone, when they introduced iOS 15, we had the option for live text that allows us to use the camera to capture text within different things we're looking at. However, we didn't have that option on the iPad until now with iPadOS 15.1. So if we go into the iPad, if you have an A12 Bionic or newer iPad, maybe go into a photo with some text, open the camera, you'll see that the iPad will now recognize text. And when it recognizes text, you'll see it highlights it, and then you can hit this button here and it will find that text and then copy it or allow you to copy and paste it. This is something they've brought to iPad that a lot of people wondered why it wasn't here already, but they've brought it with iPadOS 15.1. You can also use your keyboard to insert that text directly from the camera as well in a text field. So just like you could with the iPhone, if you go into maybe Safari, within Safari, you'll see we have the live text option, and then it opens the camera and we can use live text. So we have that option now to use live text from the camera in iPad. So that's something they've added, which was a little bit unexpected, but nice to see. Within the wallet app, you can now add a vaccination card or vaccination status. So you'll have this option if you add it within the health app and then you add it to Apple Wallet. And I can show you what it looks like, but I don't currently have support where I live. So if you're in a supported state or supported country, you'll have this option where you can add to wallet and health, and then you'll have your vaccination card there as well. So that's something they've added. I know a lot of people have wanted. And the next thing they've added has to do with the Translate app. They've added a new language option. So they've added Mandarin Chinese. If we go to languages, you'll see it there. So it says Chinese, Mandarin, China, mainland. So that's been added to the Translate app. Hopefully they'll add more languages here in the future. Now they've added some automations within the Home app. So in Home, if you go to automations and you have specific accessories, you can now automate certain accessories to do things based on triggers of HomeKit enabled things such as humidity, air quality, and light level sensor. So if you have a humidity sensor or something like that, you can now add that. So a sensor detects something, you'll see maybe a light sensor, we'll hit next. And if the light drops below a certain lumens or lux level, you can have it do something different. So maybe we'll pick 50 lux time. You can set maybe at night, and then people, you can say when I am home, and then go to next, and you can have it do something different. I can have it change based off of the time of day and the light level or more. So if I sense humidity or something else, you could trigger an alarm, for example, if maybe you sensed humidity in an area where it shouldn't have any water, things like that. So you'll have that option in the Home app now. Shortcuts gets an addition as well. If we go into shortcuts, within shortcuts, you'll see that we now have an option for overlay text. You can now overlay text on an image. So you can have it do that within the shortcuts app, and it's a pre-built action to do that. You can overlay it on GIFs or GIFs. Plus there's a new collection of games that let you pass the time with Siri. So if you use shortcuts a lot, you'll have those options as well. Now, as far as new features, that's everything within iOS 15.1, but Apple has fixed some things as well that they've told us about. So the first thing has to do with one of the storage bugs that we've had for a while. And it says photos may incorrectly report storage is full when importing photos and videos. So while it's not addressing that storage bug specifically, it is saying that when you're importing photos, it will no longer think your storage is full if you have a bunch of storage left. Now, my storage seems to be okay on this iPhone, but some people are still seeing some odd storage bugs. If we go to general and iPhone storage, let it calculate, you'll see I'm using quite a bit. There we go. And if I scroll down, some people are seeing system data take up an excessive amount of space. Whether or not this is resolved in 15.1 is hard to say, but at least you can import photos now without an issue. Now, the weather app has been updated as well, where it may not show the current temperature for your location properly, or it may display colors of animated backgrounds incorrectly. Those things have been resolved, so your temperature should be proper and the background should look correct as well, based on time of day and weather and everything else. So depending on where you live, this should change. So it should be correct and hopefully working properly if you have an A12 Bionic or newer with some of those animations. Also, many people were having issues with audio pausing all the time. So audio playing from an app may pause when locking the screen. So maybe you were in the music app, you started a song, you locked the phone, and all of a sudden the music stopped playing. My wife has actually told me that her phone recently did this, so it's good to see them address it right away where it will continue playing like it should. Also, they've fixed an issue with Wallet. So Wallet may unexpectedly quit when using VoiceOver with multiple passes. Now, if you're using VoiceOver with multiple passes, it should work properly. Also, Wi-Fi networks should now be detected properly. There was an issue where quite a few Wi-Fi networks, I ran into this myself and didn't realize it was a bug, but my Wi-Fi network sometimes just wouldn't show up. I'd have to turn off Wi-Fi, turn it back on, and then it would be detected. Now it's been resolved in this update. And something else they've fixed, I think a lot of people will appreciate. If you have an iPhone 12 series phone, it looks like they're doing the same thing they did with the iPhone 11. They've updated battery algorithms so that the iPhone 12 models will better estimate the battery capacity over time. So if you go into settings and we go to battery, under battery health, there we go. It will better understand this, know what your battery is over time, and give you more accurate readings with this. This was a problem with iPhone 11. It looks like it is with iPhone 12, and they've fixed it with this one as well. Now, as far as any additional fixes, they have not mentioned anything else other than what I just mentioned. So those things are resolved in this update, but there's nothing additional to that. Now, Apple has also brought security updates with iOS 15.1, but we don't know exactly what they are. We typically won't know what they are until it releases to the public. Now, Apple has said that macOS Monterey is releasing on the 25th of October. That's next Monday, so I would expect iOS 15.1 to release on that day. So we should have it as soon as Monday, and that's the day before most people will receive the new MacBook that Apple introduced today. Apple introduced new MacBook Pros, as well as new AirPods that we've been waiting for as well. So if we go to Apple at their Unleashed event showed off new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros, as well as new third generation AirPods with spatial audio and some different colors of HomePod mini. So all of them have been announced and the new MacBooks will ship or be available as soon as next Tuesday. So they'll probably have some recent version of macOS Monterey. So we'll have the final version then. However, Apple has confirmed that Universal Control that allows you to control the iPad with a mouse between the iPad and a Mac and back and forth, maybe a mouse, keyboard, trackpad, all of those things, that feature will be delayed and becoming later this fall. So they didn't say specifically when, but we know it's still coming. So we're waiting for that, just like we waited for SharePlay with 15.1. Now, as far as anything else, there's no additional features or changes that I'm aware of. There's some slight changes some people are seeing with tabs. My friend Steve Mosier was seeing different tab shapes here where I wasn't seeing that when in landscape, they looked more like bubbles. For me, they're square, but I'm not seeing that, or more rectangular, but others are seeing bubbles there as well. Now, as far as overall battery life, well, it will take a few days to measure that and know that for sure. However, 15.1 beta 4 has been pretty good. Some people have had good experiences, others have not. But if we take a look at today so far, I've used about a quarter of the battery and I've had 2 hours and 20 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 45 minutes of screen off time. Depending on the day, it varies greatly, but in general, you'll see this day here was great. 5 hours and 14 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 6 minutes of screen off time, and I used about 30% of the battery. So depending on the day and what you're doing, you can easily get through about 2 days with the 13 Pro Max. Now, as far as performance, so far I haven't really noticed any difference whatsoever. Even on the older devices, I didn't really notice a difference in anything, so it seems to be nice and fast and fluid, and opening things like music, you'll see here, seems to be smooth. The phone is not hot, although that was a little stuttery there, but the phone is not warm at all, where it was a little bit warm before. Now it's not warm at all, and all of these devices are running nice and cool. So it seems like this should be a decent update and be the first major fix, bug fix, and feature update with iOS 15.1. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.1 RC? Well, if you're on the betas, then absolutely. Go ahead and install it. You'll have all of the recent updates and more. However, if you're on iOS 15.0.2 and you want to try it out, well, this should be the final version or very close to it. And so it should be safe to try now, but make sure you have a backup just in case, as you will need a Windows or Mac computer in order to downgrade if you wanted to do that later. So make sure you do a backup first, then try it out. Otherwise, it should be safe to try either way, and I highly recommend it. Now, as far as the next version, iOS 15.2, I would expect that after this releases, maybe we'll start seeing betas of that within the next few days after that next week. So maybe the 26th or 27th, we'll start seeing betas of iOS 15.2 or some other version based on what they've done in the past. So look forward to that. Of course, maybe we'll have some new features with those major number updates, and I can't wait to see what Apple has on iOS 15 next. Let me know if you've found anything else in the comments below, and if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.